Now, I'm going to discuss about the concept of business. What is business and why to do business? It is an activity primarily pursued with the object of earning profit. A business is an activity that involves production, exchange of goods and services to earn profit. Business is a form of activity pursued primarily with the object of earning profits and benefits of those on whose behalf the activity is conducted. Business is a state of being busy. In economic sense, every person is engaged in some kind of work, activity, production or occupation. So business is a work, effort, activity and acts of people which are connected with the production of wealth. The village farmer who tills his land and sells his produce. The shoemaker who makes shoes on order. The various kinds of shops and the market, both rural and urban areas, dealing in various articles and commodities which are in demand. The restaurants and hotels that cater to the needs of different types of customers. The banks, insurance companies, transporters, financial institutions, cinemas and theaters, and also the line selling services, factories turning out manufacturing goods according to the needs of consumers and producers. They are some of the examples of business which is carried on so as to earn profit. Thus, the essence of business lies in people making or purchasing goods or supplying them to those who want with the object of making profit. It has nothing to do with the production or purchasing for personal consumption. Selling for profit is essential to constitute business. What are the major concepts to understand? Profit motive. So primary concept or objective of business is to earn profit. The incentive of earning profit keeps a person in business always busy and also necessary for continuity of business. The business is always dealing in goods and services. Goods produced, acquired for business purposes may be consumer goods like clothes, food chains, shoes, books, stationery, etc. Business involves production or procurement or exchange of goods. It is necessary that those goods either produced or procured or exchanged so that they can be sold for value, that is price. So production and procurement of personal consumption or presenting as gifts will not amount to business. Business includes risk and uncertainty. Every type of business involves the risk and uncertainty over which he has little or no control. That is, natural calamities, changes in the consumer tastes, habits, fashions, changes in competition, changes in social and economic conditions, shortage of raw material, power, fuel, changes in technology, etc. So every businessman tries to anticipate the future risk and uncertainty. Thus, he plans his business accordingly. Business should be continuously and regularly taken care of. There must be continuous transactions. Every time, give and take, purchase and sell must be carried on business as an activity regularly, continuously. Human economic activity is a business. That is, every person who undertakes without economic consideration will not be a part of business. That means business includes human economic activity for some gain. For starting or running a business, there must be someone to take initiative and bear the risk. So a person who takes initiative and bears risk is called entrepreneur. So entrepreneur is a key figure in every type of business. Business should create creativity, utility in goods to consumers, to use them accordingly to their preferences. So the utility may be place utility, time utility, form utility. Business should be carried on in an organization for smoothly achieving its objectives. Business needs finance, fixed or working capital. So, financial structure of a business firm determines the availability of factors of production. Business includes consumer satisfaction and welfare. The goods produced are distributed for consumers for their consumption, and the business community should always be careful about satisfaction and welfare of their ultimate consumer satisfaction. The business should satisfy social needs. That means it should provide services to the society. All business activities must be conducted in the shadow of legal and strictly in accordance with the rules and regulations of the concerned country where it is carried on. Business must be carried for the mutual benefit, for the producer, for the marketer, for the seller, and for the consumer. The idea of business is commodity, work, men, which dominates the mind or heart of a person. Business is not a static but a changing according to time and circumstances. So today we feel the need of particular commodity. A person, next day we find that particular commodity in the market. So we might feel that same commodity is useless or superfluous for us. Similarly, the concept of business is changing according to time and circumstances. Traditional concept or old concept of business, it is only known for profit. In olden days, business was conceived for the business of businesses. That means they are not for health, that is only for profit. A sole conclusive objective of business was profit maximization at any cost. There is only concept of accumulation of wealth and economic power and at the cost of social injustice. So money chasing was the primary objective of every business. Next, it has been changed to profit cum service. With the development of the economy, the business was replaced by profit comes service concept, which stated that main objective of business is to make a better product at a competitive price in a dynamic economy. So profit can be no more the main objective of business than betting in the main objective of racing, making a score the main objective of cricket, or eating is the main objective of living. So with the help of profit comes service objective. Equal importance was given to profit and service motto. With the result, the customers were more satisfied than in the past. Modern concept of business is, after 1950s, observed that profit comes service concept of business prevailed, but after 15, experts on management and business questioned the above concept and whether customer needs or more satisfaction or profits are the main objective of business. That means business is not an end but a valuable means to achieve an end, that is human welfare and public good. So presently there are several business institutions, particularly in public sector, whose main aim is to serve the society and the whole, even if they have to run at a loss. So the modern concept indicates the business is run on a dynamic way. So new and modern technology heralded the arrival of new product, leaving behind the old ones. Today growth of product may be tomorrow's gathering pot. That is, to conclude, integral part of the social system the business is carried on. So it touches every aspect of our lives. Many ways, institutional expression of our ways of life. In fact, we live in a corporate society. So business is a part of society. Thank you.